This Let's Edit with Media Composer First tutorial is brought to you by Video Guys, the leading reseller of video editing and production and post-production equipment for over 25 years. And by Boris Effects, a leading developer of visual effects, titling, motion tracking, rotoscoping, and workflow tools and plugins for broadcast, post-production, and film professionals. And by Rampant Design Tools, creators of QuickTime-based style effects for video and designed to significantly enhance content for editors, visual effects artists, and motion graphic designers. Hey everyone, Kevin P. McAuliffe here, and I am back again with another Let's Edit with MC First tutorial. And in this lesson, we're all about getting footage into MC First to start working with them in our timelines. And we're going to talk about the tool that's essential to doing that, and that is the source browser. In this lesson, we're going to give you an in-depth look at the source browser. I'm going to show you some great little tips and tricks you're going to want to know when working with it, and we're going to talk about consolidating and transcoding media, what the difference is between the two of them, and why you might want to do this instead of working with that linked to media. All right, now before we go on, I want to remind you that these tutorials are designed to get you up and running in Media Composer First, but what do you do when you're ready to take the plunge into the full version of Media Composer? You're going to want to make the transition from one application to another as smoothly as possible. If this is the situation you're in right now, why don't you head on over and check out my Mac Pro training series on the full version of Media Composer, where Lesson 1 will get you up and running in about an hour. Alright, so let's Command or Alt and Tab into Media Composer first. And I want to talk about something before we get rolling, and this is something that's important to keep in mind when you're setting up your projects. Once you've gotten in and you've created your project raster size, basically the raster dimensions of your project, you will not be able to change it when working inside this project. So keep that in mind. That is very similar to the way Media Composer works. Inside of Media Composer, you're going to get in and set the raster size. So let's just use 1920 by 1080 as an example. That's a standard 1080 HD frame size. But the key in setting up your project is the frame rate. Once you set that frame rate for a project, it is locked and you cannot change it. Everything will then conform to that frame rate, no matter if the clip is 24 frames, whether it's 30 frames, whether it's 60 frames, whether it's, 48 frames. If you've created a project, let's just use 2398 as an example, everything will conform to that frame rate. Now, many people think that that's a limitation of Media Composer, and believe it or not, I do not believe it to be. I actually think it's one of its biggest strengths, because what it ends up doing is that no matter what happens, if you think about what you want your final end product to be, what frame rate and what raster size, and you set the project to that right at the beginning, no matter what happens at the end of the project, that is the type of file that you will end up with. So keep that in mind. Okay, so let's come into our clips bin, since that seems to be an appropriate bin to be working with here. I'm going to call up my clips bin. And you'll see that inside the clips bin, I'm now given a message that says drag from source browser to add clips to the project, or more specifically, to add clips to this bin. So let's do that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on the bin, I'm going to come to input, and I'm going to come to the source browser. Now, the source browser is what you see in front of you right here. Now, a couple things that I want to point out before we go on. You'll see right here inside of the source browser settings, what does a double click do? Well, a double click by default will load clips into the source monitor. That's this monitor up here on the left-hand side, also commonly referred to as the preview window. Now we can get in and adjust that if we want to have a double click link or import our clips, but I'm just going to leave that set to load those clips into the source monitor. Now we can also choose what we want the source monitor to do, what we'd like the source browser to do when it closes. When we close it, do we want to have it close after we've linked or imported to clips? And what do we want to have happen to that footage in the source monitor when we close the source browser? Do we want it to clear that footage? In most cases you do, because if you don't, things can get a little bit tricky and a little bit confusing by what the source browser actually does. So I think that's a good idea to clear that source monitor when we close the source browser. Now, we can also tell the source browser where we would like to send our clips to the target bin. Now, because we only have one bin open, it's automatically going to default to that bin, which is fine. That's normally how I work anyways. I'm not an editor who likes to have 1,000 bins open, or in the case of Media Composer First, the maximum amount of bins that we can have is 5. So to be honest, I don't normally have all 5 bins open. I normally only have the one bin that I want to bring stuff into. Now, the next option, over here on the left-hand side, you'll see that we have link set up, and then we have an option that says import. Now, to be honest, stay away from importing. Now, the reason I say stay away from importing is because you're going to be bringing in clips that are different raster dimensions, different frame rates, and things like that. When you import a clip into Media Composer or Media Composer First, it's going to take that clip and it's going to conform it to the frame rate and the raster dimension of this project, which I would rather not do. I would rather work with media in hopefully its native format, whether it's ProRes or DNxHD or any one of the other supported codecs that you can work with inside a Media Composer. And I'd also like to maintain its original frame rate, which we can do by consolidating or transcoding the media. Now, if you decide that you'd like to import media into Media Composer First, you'll notice that as soon as you click on the import option, you're immediately told to choose your project properties. Now, to be honest, I could set this here, or we could set this when we drag our first clip into our timeline. Now, I'm going to set this here for a specific reason, and I'm going to show you why in just a second. So for the work that we're going to be doing, I want a raster size of HD. You'll notice that we're limited to SD, HD 720, and HD 1080. Now, I'm not going to say 1080p because you'll notice that you do also have a whole bunch of frame rates over here as well. Now, we are going to be going with a progressive frame rate. We're going to go with 23,976 frames per second. Now, the reason that this is important, and I'm going to say, actually, before I do that, let me cancel out of that because I want to head back over to my settings for just one second, and I want to come back to the media creation setting. I want to draw your attention to these formats or these resolutions because I did mention in the last lesson that these are all standard definition codecs. So, how do we get the HD version of these codecs? What I'm going to do is I'm going to cancel out. I'm going to come back to that import option. I'm going to set the raster dimension of this project and the frame rate to be 1080p 23976. Now when I say OK, you'll notice that I now have the resolution set down here at the bottom if I want to import this clip. And what's also going to happen if I come back to the media creation setting, you'll now see that if I drop down the video resolution, we now have the corresponding HD codecs in here to work with as well. Now, this is always a good thing to take a look at because it gives you an idea of some of the acceptable codecs or some of the acceptable resolutions to work with inside a Media Composer. And I'm going to say codecs. I don't want to say resolutions to confuse you. When I say codecs, I mean, for example, Apple ProRes is an acceptable codec to work with inside of Media Composer, meaning you don't have to recompress those files. You can actually rewrap those files to work with on both Mac and on Windows. But keep in mind that if you were using the full version of Media Composer, you can only write to ProRes on a Mac. Okay? Now, I'm just going to cancel out of this. And you know what? Let's import a clip because I want to show you what's going to happen when I import a clip. So I'm going to come to my footage folder. I'm going to come to, actually, let's step back a level here. And what I actually want to go to is footage, and I want to come to, let's come to my basketball folder here. Now, the reason I want to come to these clips is that I know that these clips are ProRes clips. Now, if you don't see the thumbnail view by default, don't worry. You can easily switch over to thumbnail view right down here in the lower left-hand corner of our footage window. You'll see I can switch between list view and frame view. They refer to it as frame view. You might hear me refer to it as thumbnail view. Basically the same thing. What we can also do is zoom in on our thumbnails, okay? And we could even get in and search for a specific clip if we needed to. One thing that I love about working in the source browser, love, 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 is I love the fact that we can skim over a clip by simply selecting the clip and skimming over it. And to be honest, you actually don't even need to select the clip. You could actually just jump to the next clip and get a preview of exactly what this clip does by just dragging the mouse over top of it. Okay, Now, if I wanted to import one of these clips, I could simply select the clip. I could come down, choose the drive I want to go to, make sure I'm going to the right target bin, and say import, and you'll see that this clip is being imported into my project. Now, with that being said, there is something else that's important for me to point out. Let's just let this finish here. And once it's done, I want to take a look at what the codec was that was used for this clip. Now, we're going to get a little bit more into bins in an upcoming lesson, so don't worry about that. But what I want to do is point out the fact that this clip was brought in as a DNX HD 115 clip. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hide Media Composer first for just a second. And I'm going to come to my media drive here. I'm going to come to my footage. I'm going to come into my basketball footage. I'm just going to pick any one of the clips. It doesn't matter which one. And what I want to do is I'm just going to open this with QuickTime Player. And the reason I want to open this with QuickTime Player is I want to show you that this clip is actually an Apple ProRes 422 file. So what happened when I imported that clip was recompressed to be Avid DNX HD 115. And I'd really rather not do that. I'd really rather not compress it. I'd rather just rewrap it as an MXF ProRes file. So how do we go about doing that? Well, how we do that is we're going to, instead of importing media, we're going to link to it, and then we're either going to consolidate or transcode. Let me show you what the difference is. I'm going to select one of these clips. Doesn't matter which one. Let's just select that one here. Actually, let me delete that one from my bin first here. Okay. And I'm going to link to this clip. There we go. You'll see that it appears in the bin. Now, how do I know that this clip is a linked to clip? Well, you'll notice that we have the clip icon, the master clip icon, with a little chain link icon right beside it. You'll also see that the video codec that's used for this clip is Apple ProRes. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back. I'm going to pick a different clip. Let's pick one from Artbeats. I'm going to come into my waterfalls footage. I'm just going to pick one of these clips. Now, I always love working with the Artbeats footage. Footage is always so great. Now, this is actually a bad example because this is a 1080p ProRes clip as well. So what I actually want to find in here is I want to find a clip that might not be a ProRes file. And let me just pick a couple in here. I'll just pick these clips here and see if any one of these are perfect. There's a photo JPEG one. And what I'm going to do is just delete these, okay? And we're going to use consolidate or transcode on these clips. So what's the difference? Well, if you select a clip and you consolidate it, and we're going to talk more about consolidating in a later lesson, because it's something that's also important to wrap your head around as well. But what I'm going to do is by consolidating, that's telling Media Composer that I would like to rewrap this clip, not recompress it, rewrap it as an MXF Apple ProRes file. Let me show you how we do this. I'm simply going to right-click on the clip, and I'm going to come down to transcode. Now, you'll remember I talked about transcoding and consolidating, but consolidating is not an option in here. Well, where you can also find the transcode option, and in Media Composer, the full version, the consolidate option, is in the clip dropdown. You'll see there's transcode again, but no consolidate. So where do I find consolidate? What I'm going to do is right-click, and I'm actually going to select transcode, and you'll see right at the top, Media Composer first will say, consolidate if I can. But if I can't, then what do I want to transcode to? Now, let's come back to our media creation settings. By default, I normally like to have the media creation settings for a 1080p 23976 project to be DNX HD 175. If this was a 1080i project, basically 1080i 30 frames per second, which is basically 5994 interlaced fields per second, I would set that to be DNX HD 145. Okay? I'm going to say OK. I'm going to come back here now. We're going to go down to transcode. You'll see once I set it over in media creation, it remembers it in the transcode window. I want to consolidate this clip if possible. And then I'm going to say go. You'll see that Media Composer first recognizes this clip as an acceptable codec to be rewrapped. And you'll see that this now is a master clip that is a ProRes HD 1080p codec clip. Now, I'm going to do the exact same thing with this photo JPEG clip because I know that photo JPEG is not an acceptable codec inside a Media Composer. It's not a user-friendly codec. Now, you're going to notice a couple things. First of all, not the same frame rate. So immediately, Media Composer first tells me that. What do you want to do? Convert, skip, or cancel. I'm just going to convert it for the purposes of what we're doing. I'm going to say go, and you'll see Media Composer First immediately recognizes not an Avid-friendly codec photo JPEG, and it flips the file using a transcode to DNX HD 175. Now, the big question is, what are acceptable codecs and what are not? Well, I'm going to include in the show notes for this tutorial a link to an article I wrote for Pro Video Coalition telling you all of the Avid-friendly codecs. But the best part is that inside of the Consolidate Transcode window, or more specifically, the Transcode window, you can just always check Consolidate, and if it's an Avid-friendly codec, it'll immediately flip it over, it'll rewrap it to an MXF file, but keep that codec, and if it's not, it'll recompress the file so that you can work with it easily. Now, I have been talking about making all this media, but what exactly has happened on our media drive? Well, let's hide out a Media Composer first, and if I come to my media drive now, you'll see that a new folder has been created called Avid Media Files. If I step in there into the MXF folder, into folder 1, here are the two clips, and what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to come back into Media Composer first, and I'm just going to grab that folder from the desktop, because you'll see that if I drag it over, there's clip 006 and clip 585 as actual Avid MXF media inside of my Avid Media Files folder. Now, why is this good? Well, guess what? If those clips were to be deleted from my system, the original master clips, because these are actual pieces of media, the media will not go offline. You could work with link to media, but I highly, highly, highly recommend against it, because there's always situations where someone will move a piece of media, delete a piece of media, and once those links are broken, especially if it's deleted, that clip is gone. Whereas if you take the clips, you consolidate or transcode them into your project, that Avid media will live on your system. So when you unplug this external drive and take it with you, you'll always have that media ready to go. And to be honest, once these clips are Avid MXF media, this media is rock solid. You very rarely will see dropped frames on supported systems when working with this media. That's one thing you're going to notice about Media Composer, is that it is a very rock solid editing application when working with this native MXF media. Now, as I wrap up this lesson, I want to take a moment to thank our sponsors, starting out with Video Guys. They are my preferred reseller for both video hardware and software, and when you're ready to make the next step to the full version of Media Composer, Video Guys will be there to help you make your upgrade as smooth as possible. You can check them out at videoguys.com, and you can use the coupon code MC101 for 5% off your Video Guys purchase. I also want to thank Boris Effects and the Boris Effects family of visual effects software, including GenArt Sapphire and Imagineer Systems Mocha. Don't forget, you can work with all their effects inside of Media Composer First by making your purchase through the Avid Marketplace, and you can check them out at boriseffects.com. And finally, I want to thank Rampant Design Tools, the leaders in QuickTime-based style elements that work perfectly inside of Media Composer First. You can check out their entire product line at rampantdesigntools.com and even download over 40 free 4K effects at 4kfree.com. And finally, if you have any questions, you have any comments, or you have any tutorial requests, you can send them to kevinpmcauliffe@gmail.com. This has been Kevin P. McAuliffe. Thanks a lot for watching.